We're joined now by Bob Deans. He's co-author of the book, Clean Energy, Common Sense, An American Call for Action on Climate Change. And Bob, are we going to see some concrete action, do you think, coming out of Warsaw?
I think they're laying the groundwork, Mike, for some real agreements by 2015 in Paris. And the idea is to build on the progress that was made in Copenhagen in 2009, where the countries that are responsible for 80% of the carbon emissions, of course, led by the United States and China, made concrete agreements to reduce our emissions by 2020. And the idea at 2015 in Paris is going to be, let's get some more ambitious targets set by 2025. So that's what they're laying the groundwork for.
And the representative from the Philippines, you were saying to me before we went on the air, made such an emotional appeal. And the interesting thing is, a year ago, it was Bhopal that hit, and he made an emotional appeal at that conference. It seems like almost every year this guy's, and now he's on a hunger strike. When does the message kind of get through to people, hey, this is serious?
You know, the message gets through when you put a human face on the kind of suffering and devastation that climate change is wreaking around the planet, when you actually put a human face on the idea that this is the most serious environmental challenge of our time. We really have to do something about it. We don't have any choice. Sure, it's tough to get 192 countries to agree to anything, but we have to do something about climate change, and that means three things in this country and around the world. Clean up, reduce the carbon emissions from our power plants, invest in energy efficiency like is happening in China and in this country, and invest in wind, solar, and other renewable sources of power and energy.
Okay, we have some graphics. I want to show you these. Let's start with this, some of the things that drive climate change. See, the red line here is greenhouse gases. It's clear how that line continues to rise every year. The other leading factors, sun, it's energy output, to land use changes, and urban pollution. Those have remained relatively stable. So is the solution to climate change really as straightforward as just reducing the greenhouse gases?
It really is the most important thing we can do, is to reduce that dangerous carbon pollution that we know is driving climate change, that we know is leading to more floods, more extreme weather, more disasters around the world, more extreme temperatures, widening deserts in Africa, melting ice in the Arctic Ocean, and really causing crop loss and failure around the world. We need to do something about it.
And our team came up with another graphic. I want to put this one up as well, showing the rise in surface temperatures around the world. This graphic shows all the factors, both natural and human, that are driving the temperature rise. Say greenhouse gas emissions just cut to zero today. Would temperatures still go up? They would, wouldn't they?
Well, not as much as they will if we don't cut our carbon emissions. And that's the thing we need to focus on. Where can we make a difference? Where can we do something about this? You know, we've had, Mike, the 14 hottest years on record have all occurred since 1997 globally. That's the problem we're dealing with right now. And cutting our carbon emissions is the one thing we can do about it.
There's a report out by the UN earlier this year, The Rise of the South. It was interesting. They talked about how the U.S. was up here in terms of emissions and how China and India were here. This was years ago, and now it's kind of reversed. And what they're talking about is Vietnam, some of these other emerging economies. You see people who are living in poverty, suddenly they're pulled up to middle class, they start buying cars, they start taking more airline trips. That really increases things, and we've got these countries in the South where these economies are coming up. This could really explode on us, couldn't it?
Well, right, and what you're talking about are symptoms of success. I mean, after all, China's doing something no country has done in the history of the world, moving hundreds of millions of people from abject poverty to the global middle class in the span of a single generation. We understand that takes a lot of energy. At the same time, China's searching hard for solutions. They're investing heavily in wind and solar, more heavily than any other nation in the world. They are talking about setting carbon caps limits by 2025. They're looking at all kinds of ways to do that. And it's important for our country, the United States, and China, the two largest carbon emitters in the world, to partner together, to work together toward this common goal.
Bob Deans, thanks for coming in and talking to us. Certainly appreciate it.
Thanks, Mike.